Hello everyone, my name is Haris Zafeiro. I'm a bioinformatician and a PhD candidate in the University of Crete, focusing on systems biology and especially on the underlying mechanisms of ecosystem functioning and microbial interactions. Today, I'm going to talk to you about dingo, a Python library for metabolic networks analysis. Thanks to high throughput sequencing technologies, the complete sequencing of a genome, especially when it comes to bacteria, it is nowadays considered as trivial. Global efforts have led to large databases supporting the annotation of the genes found in a genome. From the genome annotation, we can now get the enzymes and therefore the reactions that potentially take place in a strain. And from the sum of the reactions present, along with the corresponding constraints, we can build the metabolic network of the species. However, as the species gets more complex, the hardest it gets to both build and analyze its metabolic network. The corresponding metabolic model is the mathematical representation of what happens in the organism along with the interactions between the organism and its environment. Once we have the metabolic model, we can build its corresponding stoichiometric matrix called S, and along with the reactions constraints, we can build our model. Considering our system is at a steady state, the product of the stoichiometric matrix S and the flux vector, meaning the vector with the flux of each reaction, needs to be equal to zero. This product defines a system of linear equations. The solution space for that system is a polytop, a geometric object with flat sides that lives in a large number of dimensions. The rate of turnover of molecules throughout a metabolic pathway is called flux. As we can see in this animation video, the conversion from glucose to pyruvate in this case is vast, while the reaction that turns malate into pyruvate has a lower rate. There are multiple ways to analyze such metabolic models. Flux balance analysis is the most widely known, and it is commonly used to identify an optimal flux distribution by optimizing a linear objective function. In most cases, the objective function is a function describing the biomass of the species. Flux variability analysis evaluates the minimum and maximum range of each reaction flux that can still satisfy the constraints of the metabolic model. Both FBA and FVA are biased methods as they require an objective function and they return either a single or a pair of flux values respectively. Flux sampling, on the other hand, is an unbiased method for metabolic network analysis, providing a thorough description of the potential values a flux might get, along with the probability to get it. Sampling can be of great use, however, it's hard to get it, especially in high-dimensional polytopes, such as those we get from models as the one from the human metabolism. To this end, we implemented a multi-phase Monte Carlo sampling algorithm of ours. In our approach, we split the sampling procedure in phases, and at each phase, we use the sample to round the polytope. This improves the efficiency of the random walk in the next phase. The MMCS algorithm we implemented uses also an optimized variant of Billiard walk with faster arithmetic complexity per step. For a polytop, our Billiard walk starts from a given point, selects uniformly at random a direction, and it moves along this direction for a certain length, and it reflects on the boundary if necessary. This results a new point inside our polytop. We keep doing this process from the new sample we get after its iteration, and asymptotically, it converges to the uniform distribution over the polytope. Dingo supports all the three types of analysis that I briefly described you. Let's have a look on how to use it and what are the benefits from such analysis. So after you install Dingo, you just import the library. And once you do this, you just use the metabolic network class to build an instance of it and keep it as your model. To do this, you just need to tell Dingo where to find your metabolic network file. This model has some features that you are interested in. For example, you may see how many metabolites your model has. In our case, we use the metabolic network of E. coli, just the core of it, and we have 72 metabolites, and you can see a list of them here. You can also see how many reactions your model have, and you may also have a look on the stoichiometric matrix that corresponds to your model. The shape of your stoichiometric matrices couldn't be anything else but the number of your metabolites and the number of your reactions. In addition, your model has a biomass function. As you see here, this is an array that has zeros everywhere, but a single one value over here. If you get the index of this, you'll see that it's number 24. And now, if you just check in the list of the reactions at index 24, you see that you have a function for the biomass of E. coli. Now, just as a demonstration, if you want to sample, flag sample, you just need to import the polytope sampler class and build an instance with using your model. And here, with this command, you are ready to sample on the flag space of your model. This will take some time according to the network that you will use and according to the effective sample size that you will ask of. The effective sample size is, as you can see here, the number of effectively independent draws from the posterior distribution that the Markov chain is equivalent to. Once you do this, you are now ready to plot any flux distribution of any reaction that you'll be interested in. Assuming that you would like to see what's going on with the PYK reaction, the pyruvate kinase, you need just to find what is the index of your reaction, and then using the plot histogram function from Dingo, you can plot, as you can see here, the distribution flags. Likewise, you can use Dingo to run FBA and accordingly FVA. So that's all from us. I will be more than happy to discuss on any questions and thoughts on the Q&A section. Thank you all for your attention and enjoy the rest of the BOSC 2021.